Welcome, learners, to this session of BA Honours English Part 1, Paper 2. The topic is Prologue to the Canterbury's Tales. Geoffrey Chaucer was born in the year 1342, England. He died on the 25th of October, 1400. He was the first poet to be buried in Westminster Abbey's Poets' Corner. He was born to his parents, John Chaucer, and his mother, Agnes Copton. He attended the St. Paul's Cathedral School, where he first became acquainted with the influential writings of Virgil and Ovid. He could read French, Italian, and Latin. His father was a rich wine merchant and deputy to the king's butler. Through his father's connections, Geoffrey held important positions early in his life, serving as a noblewoman's page, diplomat, courtier, a civil servant, and a collector of scrap metals. In 1359, he joined the English army's invasion of France during the Hundred Years of Wars and was taken a prisoner. King Edward III paid the ransom in 1360. In 1366, he married Philippa de Roy, who was a lady-in-waiting to Edward III's wife. In the year 1367, he was given a life pension by the king and began traveling abroad on diplomatic missions. During trips to Italy in 1372 and 78, he discovered the works of Dante, Boccaccio, and Petrarch, each of which greatly influenced his literary endeavors. His earlier work is influenced by love poetry of the French tradition, including the Romaunt of the Rose, 1370, and Saint Cecilia, 1373, later used as the second nun's tale in the Canterbury Tales. Chaucer was named Controller of Customs on wools, skins, hides for the port of London in 1374 and continued in this post for 12 years. And now began the Italian influence, which include transitional works such as Annelida and Arcite, 1379, Parliament of Fowls, 1382, and Troilus Precede in 1385. Chaucer established a residence in Kent, where he was elected a Justice of the Peace and a Member of Parliament in 1386. His wife died the following year. His period of literary maturity is considered to begin at this time, marked by the writing of Prologue to the Canterbury Tales, which Chaucer continued to work on for many years. A treatise on the astrolabe is one of his non-fictional works. Geoffrey Chaucer was responsible for the spreading and development of the Middle English dialect. He is rightly called the father of English poetry. So now we come to the end of this session, and in our next session, we'll continue with the text of Prologue to the Canterbury Tales. Thank you.